Welcome back, everyone. This is Dakota. This is going to be on the new patch, Cyber Terror, I believe it is. I looked at the patch notes. There wasn't much new in terms of gameplay or balance changes that they made. So we'll see. Let's head into the story mode. We'll just go with another story mode run, Iron Man mode, normal. So, as a kind of overview, I try to make this thing as challenging as possible. Basically, when I do these runs, I'll try to do full clears and maximize the score. I do think Dr. Zhu is unbalanced or overpowered. His abilities make it way too simple or way too easy. I like Banks, especially regular Banks, but I like Archive Banks even more because she has the Econ chip. And if you saw my last series, I'm pretty sure I went through the whole run using Econ chip on I think everyone except for one terminal for power. Like I didn't use anything besides this thing for the console powers. So I thought that was a nice way to increase the difficulty of the missions. So even though I really like regular Banks and her ability to unlock doors, and also her paralyzer, which is a very nice starting item, I will go with Archive Banks. And if there was a way for me to do both Archive Banks and regular Banks, I would. As for my other character, I don't know what archives they added Archive Zhu this patch, but obviously I don't have him unlocked quite yet. The only two characters that I would be considering is Internationale and Deckard, based on what on their abilities. Oh shoot! No. Banks. All right. What can I say? I think I really don't like Archive Deckard. I don't use guns that much, and Internationale. Both versions of her are decent. I actually do like her wireless emitter. I don't think it's overpowered. I think it's slightly underpowered. Her custom, this item is also decent, but this item is also decent. I agree. But I do like the wireless emitter slightly more, so I'll go with her. As for my two programs, I'm gonna use Fusion. They haven't made any changes to the kind of the power generating programs. Emergency drip or power drip is the basic one. It only gives you 1 point per turn. This one basically gives you on average 1.75. So this one is my go-to. And Parasite is kind of the program I used to hack because it really allows you to unlock all the firewalls, including the high firewalls that you might see, and which is important because I want to clear everything in the mission. And I think that's about it. Okay, so let's see this. All right, so five missions here. Three of them will be this. The easy ones, and then two of them will be level 2 missions. Looking at this, this is a kind of a horrible set of missions, or horrible layout for the missions. I like to, in order to maximize the number of missions I can get to before the story mode ends in 3 days, 3 days, you generally will want to choose the route that doesn't ping-pong you across the map. So this would generally, this probably means I want to go here, then backtrack over here and here. That does mean that I start off on the two harder missions before I get to the level 1 missions. At which point the level 1 missions might become level 2 missions already. But yeah, I'm gonna have to do that because these other ones are too far away and I'm gonna spend too much time chasing them. Alright, so anyways. Level 2 missions start off. Let's see how this goes. The Nanofab Festival is basically a useful mission type if you have credits, because it'll have some special vendor there that has a lot of items for you can that you can purchase. Obviously, not the ideal first mission because you don't have many credits at the start, but I do have the econ chip. So here's the first thing I forgot to do, or I didn't do last mission, that I will do the missus mission. The econ chip scales with your hacking ability. So since International starts with a higher hacking ability, I'll use this econ chip with her, and that will give me more credits per power that I choose to morph or transfer with it. Okay, so on a level 2 mission, I don't even know even how many guards that there are, but there's more guards than on a regular level 1 mission, and there might be demons on the programs. So here it is actually possible. Alright, so there's the door there. It is actually possible for you to get a guard coming through the door at the start, so you're not safe in this first area. So I'll try to be as hidden as I can be. Alright, go ahead and activate fusion as well. You need to make sure that you do that as much as you can. Oh, the other reason why we're like normal banks is because normal banks. Okay, so archive banks can steal from behind. Okay, never mind. I wasn't sure if that was the case. All right. So let's go ahead and peek here. So unfortunately, this thing's being watched. It's possible that it's a camera that's watching it, but it's also possible that it's actually someone. So what happens here, she doesn't have, let me do this other thing and then I'll come back to that. Alright, so this guy went into this spot from this room before, and he will return to this other room as his next movement. So I can kind of plan for that scenario right now. I can even slowly go towards this area. Technically, I could get next to him, but actually, I could get next to him. But if he opens this door and there's a camera going through here, that would spot me in the open, so I'm not gonna do that. Okay, so for here, if I open this door and someone sees it, like there's a guard here and he wants to, and he inspects this area, I would actually have to knock him out or go into a hiding spot. Like this would be a hiding spot. I don't have enough movement this turn to do that, so therefore I would be committing myself to using a dart shot. And it's actually even possible, since this is a level 2 mission, that there's a security guard with armor. In this case, the armor would make this thing not work. So I'm gonna just wait one turn so that I have more action points. Yeah. Alright, so there was like a turret here, and there's the demon on the turret, and it's even possible that that turret would have went on Overwatch with me here. I'm not sure. But I will hack this power supply to deactivate the turret. If you there's two programs here. If you hack the power supply, it turns off the turret, but you don't. That means that you can only turn the turret off and on. If you hack the turret itself, that allows you to be able to turn the turret to your side, so it'll shoot the enemy instead of you, but you won't actually control you won't control that it's shooting. It's just going to be automatic shooting. So, like, generally you want to hack turrets or hack the power supply of turrets rather than turrets themselves, because you don't want to be killing without the ability to control the shot. Alright, here again I'll hack this power supply, and it's possible that I want to hack this safe too. Yeah, I will hack the safe. Next turn, there was a patrol here, so this patrol will go back to this direction, so I'm pretty sure I'm safe just waiting out here. Alright, first econ chip usage, awesome. There is a two-turn cooldown for these econ chips, so I want to use them as quickly as possible. Alright, so I want to get the power from here. I think I want to. Okay, so whatever. So this thing raised the alarm by 2, but it still gave me the monies. Alright. This is kind of a tricky spot. The camera will activate in like 2 levels, and so I will need to get into another room in order to hide. The other thing is, this guy is going to come back through this way, and he'll prevent me from going through this area. So I'm kind of banking on the fact that this thing, that I can go into this next room. Otherwise, I'm going to be in deep trouble. Alright, this is not looking that great. So there's a guard here. He's going to... there's a guard here. This guard is probably going to walk back over here. I'm not sure why I can't see him. He's probably like right here. But this guard might go over here, in which case I'll be stuck. But we'll see. We'll see that. I don't think I can do anything else. Oh, shucks. Alright, so the worst... Alright, so this is the worst of all worlds right here. This guy did go back into looking at a spot where if I try to attempt to go through this area, I'm going to be spotted, most likely. On the other hand, if I don't go out of here, then this camera is going to turn on. Let me think about this. I might just take that one turn hit on the camera. I don't know that Alright, so this is a level 1 security guard. And there's a camera drone, and it's watching this thing. Okay, great. What to do? So, let me think. If I enter into this room... Oh, I can't go back in here because this thing's definitely spotted. If I go through here, what's going to happen is he's going to probably... going to go and search in this spot right here. Is it possible that he just goes in a direct line and doesn't see me if I hide right here? It is possible, I believe, and I don't think he'd go over this way and then check here. Yeah, I'm gonna have to... I will do this. Oh, what is this? I could even try to go for this door. Technically, I guess I could also go into this area right here and then go into this, try to go into this room. Or I could go here and knock him out as he comes through this way. If I go here and then go here, I think he goes here. He looks in this direction, but he wouldn't see me right here. Do I want to bank on that though? Let's see. Maybe I can go here, open this door. I mean, I see 1, 2, 3, 4 guards. It seems unlikely that there's another guard in this room right here. So yeah, I'll sneak into this room. That's fine. Alright, so in terms of this area here, what can I do? Next turn I do need to reactivate fusion, so I need 5 power for that. I'm gonna get 3 power as in the process, so I could use 2 power right now to hack this thing. Question is whether or not I want to do that. What I sort of want to do is... Well, I can't open the door this turn. I sort of want to figure out where these guys move, if they move at all. So this guy patrols to this area, and I know this guy goes over here, so I don't really need to see his movement. Alright, so in that case... Alright, so question is, do I want to try to sneak in this room next turn? I guess I sort of do. And I'll come back to this room afterwards. And I think that's it. Wait, was that guy... It's quite possible that I open this door in any case, regardless of whether or not this guy sees it right now, because otherwise I'd have to go over here. Alright, so this guy does... Alright, so this guy does... He has heavy armor too, wow. That's amazing. Normally they only have armor 1. Alright, whatever. Well, let me think. Maybe I can sneak through here and go... where can I go? I want to go inside this room, but also be hidden from the camera drone that's going to come back this way. I actually don't see a spot. Could I go here? Would he be able to see me from here? Or is there... Alright, let me think about that. Ah, shucks. Okay, so there's another camera here. I'm gonna sidestep. I think this might be an empty room. It is not an empty room. Lovely. Alright. I don't have enough power to hack both of these before next turn. Alright, so let's hack one of these. I guess I'll hack this one. This guy will be going here next turn, so this area is safe. I'm actually gonna probably try to steal from this guy. This guy, I think he should be. Let me think. What is this guy gonna do next turn? I don't think he should be looking at this spot right here, but I'm gonna double check. He's not. Okay, so what I would like to do is, like, it's possible that I go here, peek around the corner, and then come back to this spot, because this spot is pretty safe. Pretty, but not exactly safe. Okay, so I can go here, peek, and then go back to this spot. I would be safe. Okay. Alright, so there's a bunch of consoles here. I would like nothing more than to use the econ chip for all of them. Is it possible for me to even... Let me think about this. Oh boy, so this guy is actually going to turn this way. So I actually should be standing right here. Otherwise he would actually see me at this spot, so... let me do that. And this guy, his line of sight is to this thing, so he actually won't see me at this spot, because I'm not in direct line of sight. And I think that's it. Alright, since I have nothing better to do, I'm gonna spend a turn coming over here, stealing from him, and then probably gonna come back to here. Alright, so I got a pass card. Alright, so I do need to... So this thing is a console database. This shows me where all the consoles, these things that generate power for me, or in this case, give me more credits, are. What's going to happen here is this guy's going to walk to, I believe, this spot right here. This guy will move from where he is, wherever he is in this room, to right here. I'm thinking about heading over. I want to use the econ chip this turn on one of these consoles, probably this one right here, at this spot. This means I have two excess. So if I go here, for instance, I think I might be able to. All right, so I see a camera. This thing I'm going to try to hack this turn. If I go here, I have one spare action point. So I could peek here right now. I don't see anything watching this door besides this camera, so I'm going to actually open the door. Alright, so I see this is a vendor. Don't have enough power to access it. Alright, let's convert that into more. Alright, and then this one, what do I want to do? Alright, so how's this going to play out? I would kind of like to hit up this area. I do have 1200 credits right now, so I would like to possibly go into this room and check out the shop and then exit. If possible, but if it's not possible, then I don't really care. let's figure out where this guy moves. So this guy moves to this spot. And on the following turn, I think he will even move further over here. Because I don't think this is end spot. I'm confident this isn't his end spot. Right now, the camera drone... Let's see. Last turn he was here, the camera drone was here. Camera drone should have moved back to this spot right here. So next turn, the camera drone will be here, and he will be here. So this is actually a pretty decent spot for me to be in. Alright. And I think that's all I can do right now. Alright, so this room had almost nothing besides this one corner that I didn't see. These guys, alright, these guys are kind of whatever. Alright, so I'm more interested right now to see what's up in here. The camera drone, let's see, this guy was here, he moved here, the camera drone moved there. Let's see. He moved here, the camera drone moved here. He went to check here, the camera drone went back here. Yeah, so both camera drones and the guy should be over here. Okay. So here, let's see if I can't spot where the camera drone stops. So the camera drone stops at this point right here. So I need to make sure that I don't move into a spot where that can be seen. That might be tricky. Not gonna lie. This is all... This is an interesting layout, so... What can I do here? I could technically move right here. Because I'm pretty sure... Or I could try to move... Yeah, I'm gonna have to move to the side here because I don't see any spot that would be safe in this area. Like, the camera drone I expect would move this way right here. And he's gonna turn around. Okay, so let's double check. Yeah, so this guy does move a little further north. Or in that direction that he's currently facing. Alright, so we'll see. I might be getting myself into a corner that I can't get out of, but we'll see. And it's possible that I even want to hack the camera drone this turn. You know what? So another thing that I could do here is I could hack both the turret and this camera drone and get the turret to kill the camera drone. Like, move it over here, kill it. So how would that work? That means I would hack it this turn. Do I want to do that? How confident am I of escaping this trap that I'm in right now? Not too confident, I want to say. So what's going to happen is I'm going to get to this vendor next turn, but I really don't have much cover. Like, literally nothing, because this guy's going to be right here. Yeah, so I will do that. I'm going to hack this. That's going to take all my power. That sucks. Yeah, that kind of sucks. Alright, that is going to take all my power, but... I'll do it this turn. Alright, so what can I do here? The econ chip is about will have one turn before it reactivates. I could go into this room, but then this room, I don't have enough power. So I could go to one of these one of these consoles and prepare myself to hack it. The question is which console, and I think I have an idea. I mean, if you guys were in my shoes, which one would you choose? If you want to ponder that thought. So I'm going to choose this console right here, and the reason for this is because this guy's going to go back over here this next turn. I'm going to hack it, and then I'm going to move it to this guy, and then once he comes back this way, I'll be over here. If it was the other way around, it'd be... actually, let me think about this. If I go here this turn, this guy... he's actually going to take two turns to get to this spot right here, I believe. So... I think that's the case. This seems really far away from here, so I don't think he's going to do that in one turn. So, I go here, he goes here, then I go here, and he keeps on going here, then I go here or so. Yeah, whatever. I'm pretty sure this is... okay. Okay, so this didn't turn out quite as well as I hoped. Let's go ahead and get some money here. If I had gone here to here, from there, gone over here, So here, this is definitely gonna get spotted. Here, this might get spotted. Here, it definitely won't get spotted. So, the question is whether I can go here. I'm gonna actually just go here again. Yeah, I'll just go here. Because I'll need to wait an extra turn for this thing to... for this thing, in any case. And then, next turn, I'll go over here. Alright. I think that's... fine. Alright, and here I've hacked the camera. This guy is still going this direction, so he can safely go in this area. And what I'll do is I'll probably have him get shot in this corner, or get shot in this corner. I think this corner getting shot is fine. Maybe this thing right here. Actually, I'm gonna have him get shot right here. Yeah, right there is fine. Is this thing active? Oh, okay, this thing won't shoot this drone because he's still friendly to me right now. But it will shoot it once it starts becoming hostile after it's unhacked. Alright, so let's see what's inside this thing. Alright, we have a level 2 disruptor, not that great. A plasma gun with one ammo, not that great either. Has the torque injectors, which is an awesome item for whoever's using the econ chip to use. This is by far what I'm looking at right now. Cloak, melee, you don't melee that much, or I don't melee that much for that to be useful. Dart gun. problem with these dark guns is this, it doesn't really affect armored. Celery chip, no. This EMP pack is actually could be very useful. It requires hacking 3, but I'll be getting hacking 3 pretty soon. So I'm looking at the torque injectors and this EMP pack. So I can upgrade my inventory and get the EMP pack. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. EMP pack is one of those items that you sort of need one of. You might get two, but you definitely need one of for hacking multiple devices that have demons on them or a lot of safes in the same area, like a vault. So, also, this neurodisruptor is not that bad, actually, now that I think about it. Like, she doesn't have a neurodisruptor at all. Aim pack or neurodisruptor? I think I'm more handicapped in the fact that I don't have a neurodisruptor for her, now that I think about it. So why don't I get this thing now? It's not neurodisruptor 3, which is what is really good, but it's not that often that you need to have armor piercing 2 versus 1. So, alright. I'll take the more, how would you put it? I'll take the more pragmatic route. Alright, so let's go ahead and go back into hiding. I'm pretty sure this guy moves into this corner right here. And unfortunately, I do not have enough movement to get into a safe spot. But that's probably not that necessary because... let's see, where is this guy going? Alright, so he's going to go this path right here. It's actually possible for me to just stand like right here. He's going to turn his zone of sight. Yeah, his zone of sight doesn't extend in this direction. But then again, I probably will just be going over here next turn. Yeah, or whatever. So he's gonna go here, turn, go here. Alright. I think that was it. Here, I'm gonna get 3 power. I need 5 power. The alarm level is actually going to raise to a point where it's going to take these firewalls are going to increase. So don't want to hack this thing now. I kind of do. All right, that's going to take 2 turns, but whatever. Alright, go ahead and activate fusion again. Brings me down to 0. Go ahead and go over here so I can activate the econ chip next turn. I wonder if I can go here, peek inside, and try to see this spot right here. I don't think so. Okay. As for her, so she could try to like go over here, like actually stand right here, but that would bring this guy over to this corner and he'll actually see the drone reactivate, so that's not a good idea. So I'll just wait one extra turn in this room. Standing here is fine, and then I'll go over in this area next. As for her, she's waiting out. Yeah, nothing much here. Alright, so this thing's reactivated. I'm gonna make sure that this thing... Alright, let's go ahead and go over into this area. I haven't seen the safes. There should be like 3 or 4 safes in this level. So it's kind of bad that I haven't seen it yet. Is this thing on? Alright, what the? This thing, it should be active, right? I really don't understand this thing. Like, this thing, I can see this area, which suggests that it's active, but then I toggle this thing, this is not active. Okay. Why does the power supply say inactive, but this thing is active? I don't... whatever. A telltale blip. I've never seen this one before. But we're gonna have... International could tap it, but regular hijacking will surely set off the demon. Shut the console down for a clean reboot. Reboot for cost, reboot 3 turns. Huh. I'm not sure what this means. I think this means I get power, but activate a demon. This is, I wait 3 turns and I can still activate the console again. Alright, I think that's what happened. Question is whether I want to be in this area for 3 turns. I probably don't. Can I go over here and try to find this spot or go to the vendor? Is that worthwhile? Yeah, I guess this is fine. This guy's gonna turn this way. I'm gonna head to this vendor and come back in a couple turns. Alright, so this thing's deactivated. What can I do here? Alright, I'm gonna try peeking this thing right here. Nope. Do I wanna hack these things? Probably not. Alright, so let's just go ahead and start this up. Hopefully this thing gets shot. Alright, so this guy goes straight up this way, okay. I actually think I could probably run right here. I'm pretty sure he's far enough that he wouldn't see me. I want to really see this thing and then go over to this vendor, so I'm going to try running. Let's go ahead and go sideways just a little bit. A little bit more. Alright, good. And let's go ahead and hit up this thing. Another neurodisruptor too. Penetration scanner. This might not be that bad. This combined with this thing is kind of the same thing. I think actually this augment might be better than the neuro disruptor. But regardless, I don't even have that much money. Okay, so I saw it. Let's go ahead and figure out what's in here. Alright, here are 2 of the safes. There should be a couple more still. Wow. I'm kind of regretting the fact that I didn't buy the EMP. Let me think about this. Yeah, this EMP would have been awesome right now. I can hack this thing for one and additional two. So that'll cost me 3 power, and this will unhack in 2 turns. What are the downsides of doing that? Downsides is it can do some bad demons. But I mean, I sort of have to. Yep, sort of have to. Alright, so I'm just kind of safe right now, so I'm going to be moving back to this console. Can I possibly stand here? Well, I go here, then I go here. So here, then here, then here. I don't think it saves any time. Oh no. Why is this guy getting investigated? That's not happened before. Uh-oh. I think what's gonna happen is this guy right here is gonna move to this thing. I think. Let's go ahead and move this guy over here. And she'll go over here next turn. As for her, she might as well stand as close towards the exits as possible. Alright, next turn. Hopefully I will have enough to activate fusion. If I don't, if these things actually unlock demons that drain my power, I might be screwed. Of any sort of power. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, sweet. Is it possible that this thing is going to kill another guard? I did actually forget to turn this thing off. But I would assume that this thing should show me the proper... should show me something if it was going to shoot another guard, right? Okay, so this thing is actually causing... shit. If it kills another guard, what does that mean? I'm not sure that that's a bad thing. This guard, if he's wandering around with armor too, I'm not going to be able to deal with him very well. So I might be okay with him dying. But, I don't know. Charge device. What is this? Oh, okay, there we go. So it was, in fact, so I just didn't need to wait 3 turns for that thing to reactivate. To note, next alarm level is when another guard spawns, so I have to be careful that there's another guard that spawns there, or possibly here. These are the guard rooms. In any event, can I get slightly closer towards the exit without being seen? I don't know. It's possible that this thing is safe. But, yeah. Other question is whether or not I want to actually activate these safes. Will trigger a nearby guard to investigate. Well, I mean, this guy is probably already investigating. Let's see what happens here. Okay, so this thing... Okay. Let's go ahead and... I'm probably going to actually upgrade twice here. Yeah, sure. And hopefully the guard doesn't... I'm fine with him dying right there, actually. There's like literally no way for me to prevent that, and if he's gonna investigate this area, there's no way for me to hide from him either. So sometimes stuff happens. Alright, so this thing, I'm sorry. Hun, how does this have one item on it? What? Loot one item? It shouldn't have any items on it. Say what? I guess maybe there's an item if I had more, if I had like level 5 anarchy, that it might have an item on it. Otherwise, what's the item? Like the body? Like I can loot? I can get the body? I'm not okay. This is kind of really confusing. Okay. In any case, let's go ahead and travel to this area. So a guard spawned, I believe, from right here. So Banks actually needs to go all the way to this area and steal from these two guards before I leave this building. And technically, all right, where's the safest spot for me to be? Like right here, maybe? Yeah, I guess right here, and then move over here next turn. Or even run over here next turn. Can't really see anything else. Whoa, what? What was that sound? Alright, here I'm gonna run to this area. The guard should be coming to this area over here. Here, I actually will open this door because I'm... Whew. I really want to do as much as I can. And I would have knocked out a guard if need be. So here, what's going to happen? I could go right here. The guard moves, if he was moving towards this direction, he would get to like right here and he would hear me if I ran. But then again, let me think about this. If I run, this guy might hear me when I pass by this spot, but that's fine. All right, so I'm gonna, yeah, you did hear something. It's possible this guard will come to this room. I'm gonna run. Yeah, that's fine. I'm gonna knock him out when he comes over here. Like, there was no way for me to go safely here and end my turn right here. He would just went and saw me and I'd been dead in the water. So I'm gonna run to this spot right here and knock him out when he comes through the door. Nothing more I can really do. Oh, what the? There's a guard. And there's more stuff I can't hold. Oh wow, this is one more guard than I was expecting from this level. Alright, whatever. Let me go ahead and see. I'm pretty sure there should be nothing else in this area. Okay, there isn't. Okay, so here, I kind of need to know where this guy is going. I also kind of need to somehow get more inventory space. Alright, so I took the charge pack and dropped it on the ground because I don't know where this body is going to actually be. I sort of need to know where this guy is going. Alright, so he's patrolling back in this area. I didn't recall... Oh, yes, I do. I do recall this area now. Yeah, this guy was going back and forth in this thing. So it's fine for me to be here. And it's actually, it might even be okay for me to get closer, inch closer towards this area. But not close this door. Can't close this door. Question is, do I want to even inch closer towards this thing? Or am I fine just having the body here? I can't exactly move it to a safe spot. Alright. Okay, anyways. As for her, she's basically waiting two turns here. It's possible that I could have her move over here and start maybe pickpocketing these guys and have this guy transfer over here and like get this console. The elevator, let me think about this. The elevator is right here. And this thing is going to be two turns, so yeah, it might be worth it to not have to wait two turns right here. I probably should have ran right there, but like I should have ran at the start of that turn. And I can even give her my augment as they pass by, possibly. Yeah. Alright, let's see where this guard spawned from. He spawned from here. Alright. Okay. So the question is, if he spawns from there and he goes to this area, it might be safe for me to hide the body like here or so. Or I might need to just knock him out when he comes through to this area. Alright, so I am gonna try to run here. If I run all the way right here, what's gonna happen? Yeah, I'm just like 1 millimeter short. Like one move short. If she could just like land, stop right here, that would be awesome. If she stops here, this is not great because this guy is gonna come back through this here, through this way next turn, and then like I can't actually get to the body. So what can I do? Maybe if she goes here, and then like this guy ended his turn right here. What if she goes here and transfers, like an international goes here, transfers like the augment and transfers the augment to her. That frees up a slot for her. No, that doesn't really sleep. Transfers an augment plus the econ chip to plus the scanner to her. Damn. Oh, what if I tried to move this body? I can move it right here. At that point, I could transfer. Okay, so before I move the body, I actually need to put stuff back onto the body. Oh, shoot! I can't put stuff on the body. Dang it. This is all forms of bad. Alright. So this eventually, well, she has to go in through this area anyway, so I guess her waiting an extra turn here. Main thing is getting rid of this body into like this spot right here so it's safely hidden. Alright, so let's have her run over here. She could go here and then end her turn here. Oh my lord, I forgot to close this door. Should be fine. He shouldn't be actually able to get all the way to the door next turn. But then the turn while following is he will be able to. Alright. Let's go ahead and this is gonna be. Let's drop this pass card. Let's transfer the scanner. Bring back the torque. Have international use this thing. Okay. Alright, so she can take back the custom scanner. Okay, so what's International's plan? International's plan is to get the item from here, so she does need an extra spot, and get the power from here. Her plan is to explore this area, so she's probably going to be sneaking behind this guy next turn. And then eventually even getting this charge pack. The charge pack is not that big a deal, because I will be going through this area to escape. Oh shoot, can I still pick up this item? Oh shoot, this pass card is kind of a deal. I don't have enough movement to go there though. Alright, whatever. Activate that. Can't go there. Banks needs to steal from him, I believe. All 90 of his credits. Let's go ahead and open this door from the side, just in case. Oh, shucks. Alright, so there's one more safe here that I have to hack. Oh, I would have loved to gotten that pass card again. Alright, maybe I can pick it up. I don't know. I could technically pick it up right now. but I think it's more important for me to have this body be like right here, because right here is really hidden, and then come back for it like after he goes here. Yeah, so that's hidden. I think that was everything from this level, really. Just need to make sure my exit is fine. There should be one more guard. Alright, this is the last guard. This guy took a very interesting route, so he went like here to here, so it's possible that he does a full 180. This guy is also kind of annoying. If this door had been closed, I could actually have gone through here this turn. Question is whether or not I could even close this door right now and then come back into this room. Like, run? Probably not. No, that's not possible. Yeah, this is annoying. I can't even pick up the pass card. Okay. So let's go ahead and figure out what this guy is planning on doing. He's investigating which spot. Can I tell? Alright, so he's going all the way over here, which means that he will eventually see this camera drone. Pretty sure. Yeah, he's gonna see this camera drone. Let me make sure that he doesn't actually die. He's gonna see this camera drone, and at that point he'll start moving to this thing. That'll be in a long time though, so it's not that big a deal. Alright, so here, this guy's gonna go back this way, so I guess the safest spot might be just right here. And I could drag this body. Oh shucks, I can't drag this body all the way over here. I could try to fast drag it. I think he would hear me though. No, okay. And the unfortunate part is this guy's gonna come back in this room right here and immediately block this guy from moving, but I guess that's not too bad. The main thing is that these guys aren't currently just running around all over the place in this building. It's kind of controlled chaos. Let's go ahead and go over here. I'll hack this next turn, or this thing will get unhacked next turn. And this guy will go over here next turn. Alright. Level 4. Alright. That's not too bad. I already have everything that I want to hack. Kind of hacked. Here the question is whether or not I want to run. That's probably a bad idea. I want to get over here within two turns. Alright, so this guy's going back here. He's going here. He shouldn't see me if I stand right here. And he shouldn't even see me If I stand, he's gonna do full 180. He's gonna turn. If I stand here, does he see me? He shouldn't see me. Too risky. I'll just stay over here. Alright, so do I need this pass card? Not in this area, so I won't pick up the pass card. This thing's gonna be at 1 next turn, and then I'll move here, and then it's gonna be at 0. I go to knock it down. Maybe I should stay one more turn. No, that's so bad. Alright, so this guy is further down. This thing's down. Alright, one elite. We've entered the building. Huh, this guy's on alert for some reason. Alright, so here I'm actually going to activate. Uh-oh. Oh, he didn't see the camera drone. Alright, whatever. So, I will go over here. Hopefully this guy didn't see that. Alright, and I can't get close to this thing, so I might as well skirt around him. See if I can't get this stupid pass card that somehow is. Oh, there you go. Yeah. Don't know what this means right here. Does this guy go on? Is that guy actually going hunting? All right, so I got a cloaking rig. I don't know where this guy just went. Let's go ahead and activate this thing. Okay, so this guy did see this thing. And is he close enough for me to? All right, I'm gonna go on Overwatch right here. I'm not sure exactly what his plans are. I kind of don't want to kill him, so let's go ahead and toggle this thing off. The leak came from this area right here. I don't know what this guy's plans are. I'm probably gonna knock this guy down. Is this guy on hunt mode is the question. So this guy is starting hunting. Alright, so let's drag him back into the corner, and we're good to go. Alright, so what happened here is this guy is on the top of the camera drone. Possible that I just want to knock him out. run over here next turn, run back to his corpse, and then run out. He's gonna be in hunt mode in any case, so that's probably not the worst idea. So I'm actually gonna go running to this area, because if I can, I'll knock him out and then drag him for a bit. Steal one power? What the hell is this? That is just a weird item. What? Could I have stolen that with an econ chip? Alright, so I can move him very slightly to this area right here. Would like to know where this guy is going. So he's gonna go over in this area. He's probably gonna go into this room next. They'd like to search kind of thoroughly, so they'll go into one room, then the next room, then so on. There's an enforcer that's running around here, so I'm gonna wait for the enforcer to pass by and then I'll go back through this area. These guys actually might be running around this room. I'm not exactly sure what level 5 alarm does on these later patches. Alright, so here... Yeah, I think I'm good. Alright, so let's go ahead and run here, get the power, and then run back. I could technically drag him just a little ways, so that he might be more hidden. Do I want to do that? Not really. The reason I'm not doing that is because, I don't know. I'm not sure where these guys are. This guy's definitely on hunt mode as well. Alright, so this guy's eventually getting to this room. I could go here, grab the charge pack, and then head back. What I will do is I will actually close this door, because I already have a sight of it when using the camera. So I might have been able to run that turn and then grab this charge pack and head back, but whatever. Alright, nothing doing there. Alright, so this guy's slowly heading to this thing. He's not heading there anytime fast. Or heading there very fast. Alright, so I believe he's over here. So I could probably end my turn right here, and that'd be pretty safe. Let me go ahead and go here. Yep, he's right there. Or he's over in this, he might be right there. Let's see if I can't spot him. He's probably, I mean, my guess would be he's gonna go into this room next, but it's possible that he goes over here, so I'm gonna end my turn right here. All right, as for her, we're nearing the end of the mission. It's possible that she starts knocking down people on this in this area pretty soon. Not quite yet though. All right.
Reinforcements arrived.
Whoa. Okay, so they did add some new tricks here. They immediately see where I am, or they kind of wirelessly scan, which is awesome. This is something that I wish was the case before. I'm assuming that all of them are going to this level vicinity. So, what to do about that? It might be the case that I don't get to steal from these guys, and it might even be the case that I don't get this charge pack, which is kind of really unfortunate. Let me think about that. No, I'm gonna get this charge pack. I'm just sad. I thought I probably will have to loop around back toward it, but. So what I'll do is I'll go. There's something. Oh shoot! All right, there's something noticing this thing. Probably the last enforcer. Here, what can I do? I think it's quite likely I need to run with her. Like, I need to get her to this area as quickly as possible. He's gonna hear me, and he's kinda gonna check right here, but he won't go all the way over here. Alright, hopefully I can sneak by in this area next turn. It's kind of a shame that I never got to steal from these two.
Hey, you okay?
Alright, so what can I do here? Looking at this thing, I can actually even... One. Alright, so I can go here. This is being watched, so I can sneak zigzag through this area and probably not make it to this door. Oh, I can make it to the door. Here's the question. Do I want to... Do I want to try to go over here and, like, steal from this guy, which I'm pretty sure I haven't stolen from? And then head back into this room. It will be pretty tough for me to get out of this room if they try to start searching in it. Otherwise. And if I unlock this door, it's possible that they even start looking in this room. Alright, so she has 6 action points, so she could go here, 5, 4, 3, 2. So she casts a spare action point if she wanted to do that to figure out where this guy goes. This guy goes in this room. Alright. She still has a couple of spare action points, so she can figure out where this guy even goes. Let's see. 1, 2, 5, 4, 3, steal, 2, 1. So 1 spare action point. One spare action point. So let's go ahead and figure out where this guy goes. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Are you serious? This guy immediately goes into this room? Why would he do that? Alright, so in that case... Oh gosh. In that case, I'm gonna have to... Well, obviously I can't steal and go back here. I prefer him to actually go into this room and get knocked out. Like, possibly here? I don't know where these guys goes, is the question. Alright, so this thing's gonna get noticed. This thing's also gonna get noticed. So actually this spot, I couldn't actually go all the way over here without being noticed. But who notices this? Probably this guy. Alright, so if I end here, he's still investigating that spot. He's also still investigating that spot. Alright. Let's go ahead and have her be right here. And she'll knock him out as he comes through. I guess that's the best I can do. I could technically hack this turret and have like an extra thing. Whoa, 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 what did he toss? What? Oh, wow. He's tossing out the new, these items that I'd never... Whoa. He's tossing out a wireless scanner. This is really interesting. Okay. Let's go ahead and get some credits here. Alright, so I just need to get to this point right here. Oh, if only I can get to all the way over here. And also pick up this chargeback. Planning on doing both. Let's go ahead and move this guy to a safer location. Actually, I can move him all the way here and he has two action points. I wonder who is going where in this scenario. I'm guessing this guy will go here. No, this guy's going over there. And this guy's going here? Nope. Okay. Alright. Whatever. Not that big of a deal. Alright, here I will go on Overwatch. Hopefully we can just like run across. Oh, okay. So, it looks like we can attempt to run across. All right, so what can I do here? I can go here, knock this guy down. This is a 3-turn cooldown. Is this thing off cooldown yet? No, it's not. I could go here, knock this guy down, and then enter this room. And then have her, assuming that I drop, assuming that I do some sort of transfer of items here. I want her to have the pass card, so let's go ahead and drop this thing. Transfer items, give her the pass card. Oh, I need to pick up this thing as well. Shucks. So I could knock off... this thing's way out in the open. Go here, maybe go even here. Yeah, go here and then go here. Yeah. Okay. In that case, do I want this pass card or should she have the pass card? Go here, knock him down, and then enter the room. Go here, knock him down, and then next turn enter the room. Alright. Let's go ahead and go here, knock him down. No, then she should have the pass card. Okay. Go ahead and pick up this cloaking rig again. Cannot resist the temptation of the last... the last little bit of credit. Yep. Sweet. As for her, she can't get all the way there. But she could possibly get closer. Like, if would I prefer her to be like ever so slightly closer, like maybe here even. If I go here, technically anyone who spots me would. So here's a weird thing. Technically, if I go here, anyone who sees me will go on Overwatch. They won't shoot me immediately, which means that on my turn I could close the door and then head to the exits. I think. So, am I gonna gamble on that though? Yeah, I'll gamble for that. This will be interesting, if nothing else. So I'm just gonna go like out in the open. They can see me if they want to see me, but I'm pretty sure that they don't shoot me immediately. They'll just go on Overwatch, and then I can close the door. Or they can all just not see me at the door. That's cool. Alright, so here I think I can just run. And then pick up this thing. And then run to the exit. Oh, right. I need to actually unlock the door with the card before exit. Do I have enough money? So yeah, I'll upgrade her inventory. Alright, sweet. Full clear. That was rather tough for our first mission. But I got everything. Okay, did have to kill slightly more people than I wanted to, and I don't have a lot of credits that I would love to have in order to increase my hacking. But maybe I can sell off some things. For instance, I could sell off these charge packs. And then if I increase my hacking now, not quite as much as I want, but that's still fine. This means I get a slight boost in how much my econ chip does next mission. Let's go ahead and give her the thingamajigger. No one's gonna be able to use stealth, so I'll just keep this in my inventory for now. As for weaponry, this thing has a 3-turn cooldown, and she has a slightly faster, slightly lower cooldown because of the torque injector, so I'll give it to her. Custom scanner, do I want that on... I kind of want that on International, even though she has so much less inventory space, but she does have hacking too. Okay! Okay, so next mission will be... I wonder if there was a possibility. No, next mission will be this security dispatch, then I'll get to another vendor, and then another security dispatch. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed that. That was rather an action-packed, a slow first mission, but alright, I'll see you guys next time.